On the 15th of January 1934, at about 2:13 p.m., northern Bihar experienced one of the worst earthquakes in India's history. With a magnitude of 8.4, its epicenter was in eastern Nepal, a few kilometers south of Mount Everest. In Bihar, the worst affected were the present-day administrative divisions of Tirhut, Darbhanga, Bhagalpur, Purnia, and Munger. The earthquake flattened cities and villages all across the region. Buildings and houses fell like a pack of cards. Roads and bridges collapsed. Railway lines were twisted and telephone and telegraph lines snapped. Shock waves were felt from Punjab to Assam and Bombay to Lhasa. In fact, the tower of St. Paul's Cathedral in Kolkata, 650 kilometers from the epicenter, collapsed due to the violent tectonic shift. There were thousands of casualties, both human and animal. The official death toll of people in Bihar was 7,253, while many were saved because they were out in the fields that afternoon. The great Bihar-Nepal earthquake brought untold misery in its wake on both sides in India and in Nepal. A report by the Relief Commissioner W.B. Brett mentions an eyewitness account of a planter who was driving south of Sitamarhi. He said, "My car suddenly began to rock in the most dangerous fashion. Owing to the sound of the engine, I noticed no noise, but was told such was heard from the west, a deep, terrifying rumble. As the rocking ceased, mud huts in the villages on either sides of the road began to fall. Then waterspouts, hundreds of them throwing up water and sand, were to be observed in the whole face of the country, the sand forming miniature volcanoes whilst the water spouted out of the craters." An unusual phenomenon of this earthquake was the appearance of numerous fissures and geysers in the ground. The presence of the Ganga and its many tributaries in the vicinity of the calamity caused water and sand to spout and wells to fill up short-term floods that added to the woes. The district and subdivisional officers of Bihar played an important role in relief operations, and priority was given to restoring communication and railway lines. People were pulled from the debris and numerous camp hospitals were set up. Next, towns began to be systematically cleared. On the 20th of January, 5 days after the earthquake struck, a special train was sent to Munger by the Tata Iron and Steel Company with 120 tons of iron sheets, 5 trucks of rice, and mechanics and tools, and they at once started putting up temporary buildings. The government broadcasted an appeal for food, blankets, clothing, and bandages, and many organizations came forward to offer both personal and financial help. Bihar's Congress leader Rajendra Prasad and his close colleague Anugraha Narayan Sinha set up the Bihar Central Relief Committee, and they began raising funds to help those affected by the earthquake. The committee managed to raise 28 lakhs in cash. A Viceroy's Earthquake Relief Fund was also set up, and it collected over 60 lakhs. Once the relief work was underway, the biggest challenge was repairing the damage that had been done. And for this, financial assistance was provided by the central government. Home loans were given and agricultural taxes were reduced. Mahatma Gandhi visited Bihar, and on seeing the people suffering, he wrote that the calamity was providential retribution for India's failure to eradicate untouchability. This Bihar-Nepal earthquake was the worst in the subcontinent in the modern era, and memories of it came back rushing in 2015 when Nepal was struck once again with an earthquake of 7.8 magnitude. It almost flattened the city of Kathmandu, and more than 9,000 people were reported dead. You can still get a sense of the damage done during the 1934 tragedy in the palatial quarters of Raj Darbhanga and its capital, Rajnagar. The Navlakha Palace was abandoned, and its ruins today serve as a reminder of the fury of that fateful winter afternoon.